Well, first of all, thanks for spending an hour with us. I know you guys are busy, and we appreciate you taking the time out of your day to spend with us to learn all about Episode. So, first of all, my name's David Phillips. I work in the marketing department here at Snap AV. I've been in the industry since the 90s, and I started off as an installer like you guys, and then I moved into theater design. And about 10 years ago, in fact, 10 years ago in November, I started working for Control4 in the UK and looked after the sales for the south of England for them. 5 years ago, I moved to the US, so I'm based here in Draper in Utah, close to Salt Lake City. And for the last couple of years, I've been doing marketing for all of our audio products. With me on the call here today is Matt Camp. He's our category manager. Matt, do you want to do a quick introduction?
Sure, I appreciate it. Like Dave said, I'm Matt Camp. I am based out of Charlotte, North Carolina. I am the new guy in the room compared to most of you all in the industry. I've been with Snap for about 4 years now, and Snap is my first introduction to this industry. Working on audio has just been an unbelievable experience. It's fun. I think the thing that really kind of gets me going every day is getting to wake up and really participate in this really, really fun category. So yeah, I think hopefully you guys will learn a lot from the presentation today. I can't beat Dave Phillips' accent, so he's gonna conquer the presentation today and walk us through it. I'll be here for support and answer any questions and facilitate any conversations that are needed. But like Dave said, thank you all for joining. We really appreciate it.
Thanks, Matt. Brilliant. Yeah, let's take a look at the agenda. I want to make sure that we go over what we're going to be covering today. So the first is really going to be why Episode? Why would you choose to work with this brand? Then we're going to go into some specifics on products. So we've got Signature by Episode. We're going to take a look at the Impression Series speakers, the Dynamic Series amplifiers, and then the two newest lines from us, the Response Series DSP amplifiers. And the really incredible mega subwoofers. Rosanna, that's the part you want to be listening to if you want to buy a decent sub. And then we're going to have some Q&A at the end, but we made a small change prior to this. We're going to really stop between each of these sections. So as Gary said, please post your Q&A in the Q&A box or chat amongst yourselves and us in the chat window. We're going to be stopping at the end of each section, and Matt's going to be helping us to field those questions. So let's get into it. Let's take a look at why Episode here. At Episode, we have a saying we like to use, real life sound. What this means is that we design for real world applications. These aren't designed for a showroom, but designed for you to install in a project. Creating good sound is a science, not an art. We believe in and adhere to the psychoacoustic research and learnings published by the Canadian National Research Council, the NRC. Dr. Floyd Toole and his team discovered that good loudspeaker design isn't an art, but a science. The vast majority of listeners, whether they are a beginner in the audio world or an expert in the audio world, have consistent preferences in what they deem are great loudspeakers. And here they are. We want wide dispersion, we want a flat frequency response, and very low distortion. So how do we do that at Episode? Well, we take it a step further by adding differentiators in what we do. We give uniform sound energy, so we focus on delivering the widest possible dispersion with that flat frequency response, and this ensures the off-axis listening is just as good an experience as being right in front of the speaker. A linear response. Now, what this means is our speakers maintain their sound energy levels all the way across the output gain level. So whether you're listening at a very low volume or a very high volume, it doesn't matter. They're going to sound great no matter what, with minimal distortion. Resonance-free. So our mechanical designs are focused on eliminating the unintentional transference of energy into parts of the speaker beyond the woofer. So this gives you a clean playback every time. And dynamic transient response. So the materials we choose for our speakers, both the woofer and the tweeter, in fact, are light and yet very stiff to ensure the most accurate reproduction possible while being very easy to drive. So how do we do this? As we go through the presentation, you'll see some common themes in the products we build to help us achieve great sound. We designed a special elliptical tweeter pod to help us get the broadest possible dispersion from our speakers. This means a broader area of the room gets the best possible sound and more people can enjoy the experience. You can see from the images on the screen here that familiar design across different series of speaker. They're all built from the same principles. The same is true with our special ribbed woofer design. This helps us to control the linear action of the driver, reducing distortion and giving us even more excursion in conjunction with the ultra long throw voice coils and powerful magnets we use. So you can see the design on our new mega subwoofers, our signature speakers, and even on our Impression Series speakers, all of which you're going to hear about today. Matt, is there anything you'd like to add when it comes to Y episode?
Yeah, I think the only thing to add here is, like, what does this mean for you? Like, what are you going to hear in an episode speaker that you might not otherwise hear in others? And the two things that I really like to point out, and I encourage you all to try, is, like Dave said, it's one thing to have a frequency response with the speaker on axis, but I challenge, you know, you guys to look at what that appears from an off axis response too. And really what that does, especially in distributed audio, is give you the ability to really experience that really, really wide, broad sound. The second thing is, you know, we talked about the rib surrounds, we talked about the extra long voice coils. What that allows you to do is play the speaker harder and louder without distortion and breakup. So we do a lot of A-B comparisons and you know, playing these things super, super loud to see where we can max them out. And you'll be able to play these significantly louder and harder than a lot of the other speakers in the industry. And what that really results in is that voice coil, you'll hear it actually slapping against the magnet. Additionally to that, in addition to being able to play them really, really loud, the integrity of the speaker stays intact, even at very low volumes too. So, you know, again, just all of that kind of being said is, you know, we design our speakers based on the science for the world, for the real world applications that you use them in. And I encourage you to try them if you haven't so far. I think they sound unbelievable.
No, great points. Thanks, Matt. That really goes back to the real life sound statement at the beginning of this. You know, it's awesome to have that sweet spot with a nice pair of hi-fi speakers. But the reality is that a lot of times we're not listening to music like that at all. You know, we're moving around the room. There's more than one people in the room. You've got seating in places where it isn't ideal. And so having a speaker and a product line and a brand even that's designed for real homes, I think is really important and a good message. All right, well, so now we're going to dive into some product information. We're going to start with our flagship speaker line, Signature by Episode. So we have 32 SKUs here, 32 speakers with three different performance levels in both an in-ceiling and in-wall configurations. All of the models feature our pushlock mounting technology, which really has to be seen to be believed. And I've got a speaker here that I'm going to demo to you in a second. So why choose Signature? Number one, that sound quality. You know, we've gone all out, premium components and sound backed by science, as we've spoken about. Built using your feedback. So we listened to all of your feedback on our previous speaker models and delivered exactly what you want. Limited distribution. These are rewards partner level access only. They're only available to Snap AV customers. And your install your way, the most versatile speaker on the market. And we're going to find out about all of these things right now. So incredible sound. We went all out with the performance of Signature. We combined the scientific research from the NRC with cutting edge design and manufacturing to deliver this incredible line. As we've mentioned, we know that good sound comprises of three things: flat frequency response, wide dispersion, and low distortion. And you can see here, we've made those things happen with our elliptical tweeter pod to improve and control dispersion, ribbed woofer surrounds to reduce distortion at high volume, and all premium components to ensure the very best in sound quality. These things sound absolutely fantastic. But we didn't just focus on the sound. We listened to our dealers' feedback and what they wanted from a speaker and delivered on everything that you guys asked for. You wanted a faster install, but you also wanted a faster removal of the speaker. You wanted more choice on how to install the speaker. You wanted stronger magnets and a better fitting grill and many others. We took all of your feedback into account, and maybe I'll wait and stop sharing my screen to show you the pushlock technology. So I think I'll wait till the Q&A section at the end to show you this, but You will absolutely love installing these. I've never, in the thousands of speakers I've installed over the years, I've never installed a speaker this quick. That's so easy to be removed as well. So the push lock works in a really simple way. The round red button on the front of the product, you just push it, very simple, and that engages the dog leg with incredible holding force. It's just so simple. You can release a dog with a simple push and a quarter turn of a screwdriver on the screw that connects to the dog. It couldn't be easier. The screws also allow you to cinch down the dog for even more security. So if you imagine you have uneven sheetrock on the ceiling or a heavily textured ceiling, those screws allow you just to cinch that speaker down for a really firm fit. Limited distribution. So these are built for you guys. They are available only to our rewards partner members. We don't sell them online. We don't do direct to consumer marketing. Signature speaker purchases count towards your reward status with us as well. Of course, we have price protection and really fantastic margins too. So the story here is really, you think about buying a speaker brand that makes sense for your business as well as your customers. So these are going to sound fantastic, but they're going to be good for your business. And the thing I love most about this as an ex-installer myself is the flexibility you have with Signature. Let's take a look at the animation on the screen for a minute here. From left to right, or I hope so, in case my screen is mirrored, we have the grill, the motor unit, the cradle, and the enclosure. I love this animation. It's available on our website if anybody needs it to use on your own site. So what this does, having this completely modular speaker design, gives us the opportunity to install the speaker in several different ways. So you can choose to install the whole speaker with just one trip up the ladder, no problem. Put the wires on the back, put it in the hole, press the four buttons, walk away, job done. Alternatively, you can choose a two-step install. That way you can go up the ladder with just that cradle, fit that in the ceiling, and then the motor unit installs into that cradle with no tools whatsoever. Maybe you want to control sound in adjacent rooms. It's no problem. You can just add on the optional enclosure right on the back of the speaker. Maybe you're working with a builder and they don't want to pay you up front for the speakers in every room. Maybe they want to wait for the homeowner to come in so they can choose the grade of speakers they want to buy. That's no problem too. You can just install the cradle and the grill to reserve your spot in the ceiling. And that also works for pressure testing too, by the way, by putting on the enclosure on the back. So in a commercial project, for example, you don't have to install an expensive speaker in an area that's not secured, but you can still get the pressure testing done. And finally, because that motor unit just drops out with zero tools, this is the easiest speaker out there for you to actually upgrade your customers from a 3 series to a 5 series or a 5 series to a 7 series. So as I said, from an ex-installer, this is magic. This is a dream. And finally, we've made sure that all of our existing accessories work great with Signature. Everything from the cutouts are the same, the new construction brackets work just fine, the back boxes match, and then the grills are available too. So let's review. Incredible sound, built using your feedback, limited distribution, and the most versatile speaker on the market. An awesome line. Matt, do we have any questions come in?
We had one question that was asked around how are these sold in eaches or pairs? And so every Signature speaker is sold as an each. And the reason for that is obviously to, again, give you guys the flexibility that you need or want depending on your install needs. And the only thing I'd add on to that as well, and it's not really applicable to the question, but it reminds me, I think, you know, just take a look if you get an opportunity when you look at these speakers, when we talk about the amount of energy that went into designing not just the speaker, but also the box itself. I mean, the boxes are extremely heavy duty corrugate. There's no trash, it's all recyclable. Every speaker comes with dust covers, whether you've purchased the speaker or just the cradle, you can purchase the cradle separately. But the amount of attention and detail that went into not only the design of the speaker, but the packaging and this is all just based on feedback from you all on what you're looking for in a speaker. So,
And we got one more comment here from Jason in the chat. He said, very simple install, and clients have given feedback on how low profile the grills are. And then he asked, what's a pressure test? Matt, do you want to take that one, or do you want me to grab it?
Go for it. I can fill in.
Cool. So pressure testing is done more and more in residential buildings. And certainly this is a requirement in Europe for the efficiency of the house. And so what they'll do is they'll close all the doors, close all the windows, and then pressurize the building and check for air leaks and so on and so forth. And so it's really a measure of efficiency from a heating and cooling perspective. It's definitely required in commercial buildings too. And if you have just cut a hole in the ceiling, that's going to mess with that. And so by putting on the sealed enclosure to the speaker and fitting the speaker in the ceiling, that gives you a much more efficient pressure test. I've stopped sharing my screen because I want to show you. I want to show you the speaker here. So here's the button on the front, and you can see the dogleg on the side. I'm just going to press this button. If you're wearing headphones, maybe take them out because this click might be really loud. So anyway, I'm going to press it now. So here we go. Red button. It's like super quick, super strong. Awesome design.
So it's one of the most satisfying feelings of putting a speaker in, is just holding that into the hole and pushing the four buttons and hearing it clank behind the sheetrock. It's pretty awesome. I
absolutely love it. So if there's no more questions, let's move on to our next topic. The episode impression speakers, which I absolutely love. So what are the impression series? This is a line built to satisfy the needs of designers and customers alike by combining the proven episode science-based sound with a very small 5-inch grill. And now this is designed to match 5-inch light fixtures. By the way, episode line already has a 4-inch in-ceiling speaker, but it has a 4-inch driver. This is the difference. With a 4-inch driver, obviously you need the kind of carcass of the speaker, and the grill's bigger than that, so you end up with a 7.5-inch grill. The Impression Series speakers here have a 5-inch grill, and so we use a smaller 3.5-inch driver, and it's designed very specifically to match up with those light fittings. We use a 3/4-inch soft dome tweeter. We have a 3.5-inch carbon aramid fiber woofer, and you can read through this in your own time. I know we're kind of rushing through this right now. Important to me is that this ships with both round and square white grills. So no matter what the light fixture you're matching, there's an option in the box. These can be retrofitted through a simple 4-inch hole. So cut your 4-inch hole, the speakers fit right through. The second product in the Impression Series is the bandpass subwoofer. So we've got a 6.5-inch dual coil woofer in this box. It comes with a 22-inch port tube. And again, it comes with the round and square grill. Obviously, the size of this thing, it really has to be installed prior to drywall going up. However, if you have access to the ceiling or the void above the ceiling, you can install it from above post-drywall going up. There's also worth mentioning here an automatic protection circuit that protects the subwoofer in the event of being overdriven in an extreme way. This happens mostly when a customer is switching between sources. So he might have a satellite receiver or a cable box, which has a relatively low output level, and maybe a high resolution audio source, which obviously has a fantastic output level. So if a customer is listening to satellite TV very loud and switches to some high resolution audio, you might end up with that extreme spike in volume. So the protection circuit will just protect the subwoofer from being damaged, and then automatically reconnect once the volume's back at a safe level. And this fits between 2x10 joists. So why would you choose these? Number one, just delighting those designers. You know, we've got the audio quality, and now we've got the looks that's going to satisfy designers. Sound based on science. We've spoken about this before, and we'll get into it some more. The multiple speaker configurations, this is a really big deal to me. For different size rooms, you can combine different amounts of satellites and subwoofers, but the key here is that they are all driven from a single zone of amplification. That's a big deal. And dealer focus, tons of accessories and features for easy install. Let's take a look at them. So we've taken special care to match these grills of both the satellite and the subwoofer to common 5-inch light fixtures. Remember, white square and round grills, excuse me, are supplied in the box. I took a quick look on a famous hardware store's website, and there was over 300 results for 5-inch light fixtures. So there's plenty of opportunity to match these. I think this is a good opportunity, actually, to build a good working relationship with designers on your projects. Often in my past, at least, and you guys can let me know in the chat if this is the same for you, but the AV guy has kind of been seen as a bit of a nuisance on projects, you know, kind of ruining the line of lights and putting stuff that's going to ruin the design of the project. But I see this as an opportunity to position yourself as a really valuable partner to the designers. And here's a couple of examples of some of those light fittings that this speaker series will match. So you've got round and square light fitting styles. Sound, Bass and Science, we've covered this already, but you know that we follow the National Research Council's advice, and we just make sure that we have that wide dispersion, flat frequency response and low distortion. And even though these speakers are very tiny, just that 5-inch grill and 3.5-inch woofer, we've still stuck to our principles and built in that elliptical waveguide for the tweeter and the rib surround with large magnets on the woofers. So now the fun part for me is the multiple configurations. We bundled these up on our website in a 4.1 bundle and a 2.1 bundle, so they're easy to purchase for you. But you can also install the system in a number of different ways, and they're listed here on the screen. You can do 4 satellites, 2 subwoofers, just 4 satellites, just 2 satellites, and even just 1 subwoofer. And the real magic here is that they wire up in a special configuration. It's all in the install guide. But they will only take up 1 channel of amplification. So this is going to make your life easier. It's going to make the customer, they're going to make the system more affordable for the customer, you know, just by using 1 channel of amplification, and really allows you to get more out of your customer's money. We have replacement grills. As we've spoken about a couple of times now, we have these square and round white grills in the box. We also have black versions of both, and they are paintable. As well as the grills, we offer 2 great install accessories. We have the new construction bracket that can be mounted right up against the joist in the same way a lot of recessed lighting is installed. You can use this to reserve your spot in the ceiling to avoid any surprises during install, to make sure no HVAC ducting or pipework gets in the way. We also offer an enclosure for the Impression Series speakers. So this just helps reduce the sound transmission from adjacent room and gives you a predictable airspace to work with, so the speaker's gonna sound the same every time. When using that enclosure, you do have to use the new construction bracket, and they both have to be installed prior to drywall going up. So a quick refresher, we want to delight designers with these speakers. The sound quality is really fantastic. The options for configuration, multiple speakers all running from that single zone of amplification, is really cool. And all of the accessories that help you to install the speaker and give you peace of mind. Matt, do we have any questions?
Yeah, we had a few come in, one of which you just covered, but does the Impression Series speakers come with a back box? Or are they available? Just talked about that. So yes, the pre-construction brackets and the back boxes are optional. And as noted, the back box does require you to put it in at the pre-construction stage, mainly because of the volume size that's necessary to get the right acoustical performance. I'll let you take this one, Dave, if you'd like. Does the sub do vibration cancellation? I did type an answer in for that, but I don't know if you want to kind of just touch on some of the features of the dampening pads and the isolation and stuff like that.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, as Matt says, there's dampening pads to kind of help isolate the brackets and the enclosure from your joists. So that is going to help for sure. So I'd recommend using them. There's 1 driver in there. I believe it's a dual voice coil woofer. So there's no kind of opposing drivers up there or anything, just that single driver.
And then the last question, which has taken us back a little bit to the signature speakers, the question was what comes with the signature speaker, a grill, cradle, enclosure, and also type down an answer for this one. But every signature speaker comes with a white thin bezel grill and every speaker also includes the cradle. We've got a number of accessories in grills off the shelf that don't need to be customized. You can get them available in white and black. You can get them in round or square. You can get them in bezel or bezel-less. We've got a number of pre-construction brackets that Dave touched on. Dave touched on the back boxes as well. And then you can also purchase the cradle as a separate accessory with the intention being that if you want to pre-wire a house and not include the speaker, let's say you're concerned about folks on the job site or, you know, potentially messing up the speaker with sheetrock dust or painting or whatever it might be, you can put the cradle in with the back box or without the back box. You can choose to put the grill over the top so it actually looks like there's a speaker there. And that's what we refer to as kind of a dummy speaker install. So depending on your business model and what type of installs you do, you may opt to pre-wire a house, put the cradles in, put the grills on for a very, very low cost, and then work to upsell the end customer with the speakers. Obviously, with the cradles and the grills already being in place, you can come back at any point in time without any tools to do that. So.
Yeah, I want to add to that quickly with the paint guard that comes in the box. It's kind of hard to see because it's see-through, but this comes attached to every speaker too. It goes right to the edge of the speaker cradle. And so you can leave these on as well to protect the speaker. And then there's obviously the cutout template in the box too, as I had a box right next to me. All right,
I think... couple questions come in. Is a home pressure sealed with the cradle in enclosure? It's not completely sealed because of the mechanism with the dog, although the speaker to the back box is a sealed enclosure. But with that paint guard that Dave just mentioned also, that goes all the way to the edge and does cover up the opening for where you put the screwdriver to retreat the dog. And so you can actually, the magnets are strong enough on this where you can actually put the speaker in, put the paint guard on with the back box, and then also put the grill over the top, which creates a very, very tight seal to the home. So,
Worth mentioning that enclosure has, is it rubber or felt, Matt? I can't remember.
On the gasket?
Yeah, that's right.
It's like a neoprene.
Okay, yeah, so that that runs around the enclosure's face that mates up with the back of the cradle. And so you get this really lovely tight seal.
We had another question that is, what is the difference between the sound of the Signature and the Impression series?
Good question. The first is really the driver size. I don't have on my screen right now the frequency responses, but just the larger woofer size of the Signature speakers. So I think we do a 5, a 6, and an 8, give or take a half inch here or there, will produce more bass. We also have different driver materials across the two lines. And so that's, I think, going to be your main difference. I think that I would, if it was in my house, I would definitely be looking at the 4.1 and 2.1 bundles for the Impression series just to get that low-end reinforcement of bass from the bandpass subwoofer, whereas the larger Signature speakers with the much larger surface area of the driver, you wouldn't need to run a subwoofer. Of course you absolutely can and should for extra bass. He doesn't like bass, but yeah, these are totally capable of being run without a sub. There's a lot of other differences too. You know, it's not just the sound quality. There's that install speed, there's the requirements of the customer. So what I think we've tried to do here is give you guys a toolbox of speakers, like this arsenal of speakers that you can go and kind of interview your customer, you know, have that conversation with your customer and find out what their requirements are. Do they want very high sound pressure levels? Do they want huge bass? Cool, we've got a solution for that. Do they want them to blend into their environment? We've got a solution for that too. Any other questions?
Yep, couple... Yeah, I think just to put a bow on what you said, I think it really comes down to the type of install that you're looking for. You're going to get a lot more bass response out of the signature speakers. You're going to get a lot more aesthetically discreet speakers out of the Impression Series. So depending on what you're looking for, the Impression Series sounds unbelievable, but physics is physics. The smaller the driver, the less air you can move. So again, really just depending on what the application is. Does the 4.1 speaker system not come with an amp, and what amp would you recommend in the line?
Good question. So it does not come with an amplifier. Just like most of the speakers we sell, they come with just the speakers themselves, and then you can choose the amplifier that's right for you. In terms of what amplifier would we recommend, we have recommended that you would put them on zone 2 or 3 or whatever of an AV receiver. That's a perfectly acceptable way to run them. We also have some amplifiers that we're going to cover in the next few slides, which will be a great match for them. But ultimately, we wouldn't necessarily not recommend an amplifier, you know. And you can always reach out to us too if you've got questions about, will this amp work with my speakers?
Yeah, I think to be very overt and clear, the Impression speaker system delivers anywhere between a 4-ohm and an 8-ohm nominal impedance to the amp, which allows you to use any standard AV receiver or multi-channel amplifier. On the back of the speaker, there's actually a little switch. Depending on whether or not you have a sub in the system, which helps to direct, it's a high pass filter switch, which allows the overall system to maintain that impedance integrity. So intention being you can use it on really any standard amplifier. And that kind of plays into the next comment, which is, should I install the sub off of a Matrix style 16 channel amp? And the answer is you absolutely could.
Perfect. Okay, we are 34 minutes in, 26 minutes left, 3 sessions to go.
Crank it out.
Loving this group, very active. Keep the questions coming in. Keeps it fun, interesting for us, and we love helping. So let's move on. Let's take a look at the Dynamic Series amplifiers from Episode. So the Dynamic Power Amps from Episode pack a serious punch. High efficiency design, is key on these products. We've got plenty of choice with the 2, 8, 12, and 16 channel models, and they sound amazing. And yes, these would be a great match for the Impression Series speakers. We have a very cool running ice power design. It produces a whole lot less heat than traditional amplifiers, which is better and safer for your rack installs. So why would you choose them? We've got the choice of the 2, 8, 12, and 16 channel models. The performance is fantastic with tried and tested ice power design. Bass in any space, so this is a fun one. There's a dedicated subwoofer output for every single zone on these power amps, and they're install friendly. Features for you to get the job done fast. 4 models means you can pick just the right amount of amplification you want for your project, saving the customer money. We have a 2, 8, 12, and 16 channel model available. In fact, what a lot of people do is actually choose the next model up from the amount of zones they have, just in case a customer decides to upgrade another couple of zones of audio in the future. These amps have up to 1,000 watts of peak power and an impressive signal-to-noise ratio of 103 dB. So the amps have tried and tested ice power technology built in. These modules are light, powerful, and sound fantastic. One of the bits of feedback we get from this product, actually, is just how light they are. Very, very easy from an install perspective, but you will love how they sound, and so will your customers. As always, delivering a great sounding product is one of the most important things to us, just as it is to you and your customers. So this is one of my favorite features of this line of amplifiers. It's the dedicated subwoofer output per zone. So what does this mean for you? It's going to greatly reduce the wiring and programming complexity of your installs. So there's no need to hijack an extra output on your matrix switch when adding a subwoofer to a multi-room audio zone. The subamp can wire directly to the power amplifier, meaning you've got automatically matched sub volume to your audio channels in the room. And there's no programming time. This is completely done post-programming. And of course, who doesn't want more bass in their rooms, as we've spoken about before? So I see this as a really good opportunity for you to sell more subwoofers with less of the install headaches. As well as a dedicated subwoofer output for every zone, this amp has got a ton of install-friendly features. You can power up the amp by using the 12-volt trigger for efficiency, Audio Sense for legacy systems, or simply leave the cool running unit on all the time. The outputs can be bridged to deliver more power into a single zone, which is perfect for demanding outdoor systems or very large zones, very demanding speakers. We have global input, two different global inputs, in fact, for sharing across all of the outputs. And we also have rack ears included. So this is a great all-round product for your multi-room audio projects. So we give you more choice. We give you fantastic audio quality. Ice Power do some fantastic work. The easy addition of a subwoofer, making your customers happier and making you more money. And the fact that these are just a dream to install with tons of cool features. Matt, do we have any questions?
We have one question specific to the amp around any quality differences between using the Phoenix connector versus right and left connectors on the RCA. I was typing out a question, but we can try and or typing out an answer, I should say. We can answer that here if you'd like. You want me to take a stab at it, or do you'd like to?
Yeah, go. If you can take a stab, I can add to it.
Sure. I believe the question is being asked about the output stage of the amp, as to whether or not it makes a acoustical performance difference on whether or not we're using RCAs versus the Phoenix. And there's little to no difference acoustically between the two. The benefit of the Phoenix connector is that you can actually wire in the speakers into the Phoenix connector, and then that Phoenix connector itself is removable from the back of the amplifier. So if you ever want to take a zone of audio and move it to a different zone, you can. And I know that's a different question. If you ever, for whatever reason, need to change the amplifier out, you can fix all your wiring to your rack and then pull the amp by removing those Phoenix connectors very easily and quickly without having to modify it. So anything to add there, Dave?
No, I don't think so. I think that's good. Yeah, I think you covered it nicely. Yeah, the Phoenix connectors are a really common type of speaker connection on the market, and you really find them a lot on multi-room audio products just because they are so easy to install. And as Matt said, they can easily be removed one by one and switched out really simply. So yeah, very, very commonly used, great quality. It's the right way to do it.
And then one last question, do they have volume control?
Good question. No, they don't. These are just power amplifiers, and so you'd need to pair them with an audio matrix switch, which has the preamp stage in already. So maybe your control system of choice has a variable output audio matrix switch, So these are designed to be paired with an audio matrix switch. I mean, there's a million other ways you can use a power amplifier. But that's really the primary use case. Yeah, I mean, you could connect them to a Sonos Connect, right? Is that the new name? What's the latest name for the Sonos product? I think it's a Connect.
You've got the Sonos port and the Sonos amp.
Okay, I'm like still 10, 15 years behind in language here. but you know what I mean, right? It's got a variable audio output. And so you could connect that to one of our amplifiers, and that would handle the preamp stage. But definitely the primary use case is that audio matrix switch.
And there is a input gain adjustment to make sure that you can either level all the zones based on your source or adjust the gain to ensure that you're not damaging the amplifier stage or the speakers.
That's a great point to bring up. Yeah, different speakers have different sensitivities, and so they're easier or harder to drive with the same amount of power. And so you might want to be matching the volume levels of each speaker zone across a project. Maybe it's a commercial project, or you know, a home with a hallway that connects to a kitchen that connects to a living room. So that's a great feature to call out. All right, I think we're ready to move on to our newer products here. These are just announced in the last couple of weeks, and we are so excited about these. we're going to talk about the Response Series amplifiers. So these products are different for episode, and they've got some smart tricks built in. These are four new awesome amplifiers that have everything built into one box to make your installs quick and easy. So what's special about them? Multi-room audio in one box. You know, we spoke about that last product, the power amp, still needing an audio matrix switch to add on to the front end of it. Well, this is everything you need in one box. So we have a preamp stage, switching, amplifiers, and that DSP stage, which we'll get into in just 1 second. These are smarter amps. So we included IP control. These are oversee enabled, and they've got a gorgeous and easy to use web user interface. Every install sounds great, and we'll talk about DSP and how we do that in a second. And they are full of dealer-focused features to help you with install and setup. So multi-room audio in one box, this is exciting to me. The Response amps have everything you need to give your customers a fantastic multi-room audio experience all in a single box. So you can see here on the side, we've got the DSP, we've got the audio matrix switch, which handles the switching side and the preamplification side, so volume control and muting, so on and so forth. And then all the power amps are in this box too. So you literally just need to add your sources and you're done. So this is going to help reduce on things like wiring, it's going to help reduce rack space, and it's going to help save you time and still deliver an awesome customer experience. We do a 2-channel, 8-channel, 12-channel, and 16-channel models. All of them are 100 watts per channel at 4-ohm and 50 watts per channel at 8-ohm, with the exception of 2-channel, which is 200 watts per channel at 4-ohm and 100 at 8-ohm. Now, obviously, the 8, 12, and 16-channel have the ability to matrix the sources. So what that means is input one could be a Sonos box, for example. Input one can go to any and all of the outputs of the product. The 2-channel obviously only has one input and one output, so the matrix switching stage is just not built in. We still have all the DSP and volume control, though. It just doesn't switch. Let's take a look at this back panel. We have analog source inputs with loop outputs, which you can use to send the same source onto an AVR or even another amplifier. The sub outs for every zone, this is just like the dynamic series amps, but we have a sub out for every zone, giving you the opportunity to upsell with an architectural subwoofer for any and all zones in the customer's project. Those easy to use Phoenix connectors you see again, providing speaker connectivity. We have IR in and out, infrared in and out for basic control. But things get really interesting once we get to that Ethernet port. So let's talk about that for just a second. These amps are smart. We have oversee built in for monitoring, maintenance, and remote firmware updates, which is just so awesome and cool for an amplifier. We get this beautiful, rich web user interface built into the product. So all you need to do is just type in the IP address of the amplifier into a browser and you're good to go. You're going to get that beautiful user interface to help you configure the amp from anywhere in the home, right? Once it's on the network, you can be, sitting in your vehicle outside the project on your laptop configuring these amps. It's a really cool feature. And of course, control over IP. So we've got control system drivers for all of the major control systems that you can see on the screen there. And I think we published the API too, so you can even build your own. So how do we get it to sound good? Well, one of the most effective solutions to overcoming acoustic challenges in a project is using room tuning, which can be achieved using tools like parametric EQ that you can see on the screen here. So what a parametric equalizer does is it lets us boost or cut key frequencies from the audio source, helping to minimize the effects of surfaces that are present in the room. And you'll need digital signal processing tools with EQ controls that provide a wide range of frequencies that can be adjusted and fine-tuned, like custom frequency selection, gain, which is that boost or cutting of the frequency, and adjustment of what's called Q, which is the bandwidth of the frequency you're adjusting. So what do we use room tuning for? You've all been in rooms where you've got lots of glass or hard tile, and they just sound too bright. Or maybe you've experienced a room that's got very thick carpet, very heavy curtains, big fluffy sofas, and the room sound dull and dead. Room tuning can help you to correct that. So often the first steps to improving sound is to optimize the settings for the speakers being used in the room too. We call this speaker tuning, and it can be achieved by selecting electronics that have kind of settings built in that work with the speakers you're using. We call them speaker presets. So what we've done here is we've built in all of the acoustic properties of our signature line of speakers right into the amplifier. So all you need to do is connect up to that web user interface, choose the model of signature speaker you're using, and the curve of the speaker will be preloaded in, instantly improving the sound. Then you can go on and do that room tuning stage and really make the system sound fantastic. So for larger rooms or rooms that are lacking in bass from the main speakers, this is where you would add that subwoofer. But we go a step further with this project, with this product. It's not enough just to add a sub. So we decided that we wanted to add in high pass and low pass filters for each of the outputs here. What that does is it stops sending low frequency information to your speakers, and it won't send high frequency information to your subwoofer. So we use low pass and high pass filters to make sure that the speaker only receives the frequencies that it's capable of producing. That gives you the ability to have a much higher output system. It's not going to tax your speakers. It's not going to overtax your speakers by forcing them to produce frequencies that are outside of the frequency range they can reproduce. And of course, we went to the effort of adding a ton of install-friendly features to keep your projects running smoothly. From output grouping to amp bridging, clever audio override features that can be used in residential and commercial applications, to those quick release Phoenix connectors for speaker wires and the included rack ears, these really are built for the installer. So why would you choose them? Let's do a quick review. Everything you need for an audio system is included in this one box. Just add a source and your speakers. They're smart, IP controlled, Oversee enabled, the web UI that is super simple and easy to use. We've made efforts to make sure they sound fantastic with all the DSP features built in. And again, like everything Episode does, we built them with you in mind. Matt, do we have any questions?
There were a couple that I answered live. I know we got one more section to get through. I think the big one here is there's a question around how you control volume on these, and simply put, there are a number of ways to interact with the amp. The primary one being through that network control. And so there's APIs available on the website if you need to create your own driver for whatever reason, but there are commands that you issue to the amp, most commonly through IP, that would adjust the output volume stage of the amp. There was also a question about URC integration, which we're working on as well.
Perfect. Thanks, Matt. Okay, well, we'll just power on through, and then we can have some more Q&A just at the end here. Now we're going to talk about the mega subwoofers, and these are a lot of fun. So these are a brand new addition, a premium addition, really, to the Episode subwoofer lineup, designed to deliver incredible bass with a gorgeous form factor. We have 7 different models, multiple finishes, and some great features built in. And before I get going, I'm just going to tell a quick story about this where back in February, it might have even been January this year, when I was in Charlotte, way before these products were released, Matt here dragged me into the demo room in the Snap AV headquarters down there. And he was like a kid in a candy shop. He was so happy and excited. He dragged me into this room to hear one of these subwoofers. And we spent about 10 minutes really blasting it through the test system down there. And during the demo, we heard this big crash. And this is the first time in my life that an ornament on a shelf has been dislodged by nothing but bass. So these are epic subwoofers, incredible. They sound fantastic, and they have incredible room pressurization, enough to apparently move objects. onto the floor. Luckily, nothing was broken, but yeah, you should check these out. So there's kind of two series within the line. We have the D series, which gives us the ability to add two drivers. So they have dual opposing drivers, one on either side of the cabinet facing out. We do an 8, a 10, and a 12-inch model. We use bash amplification anywhere from 650 watts to 1,000 watts, depending on the model. And they come in a really beautiful kind of piano black, glossy black, this premium walnut finish you see on the screen. The S series have a single driver. We have one extra model in this lineup. We go the matching 8, 10, and 12, but we also go up to a 15-inch driver in this model. Bash amplification again, 120 watts all the way through to 650. And these have a slightly different finish, a more modern looking matte black. So here's why you would choose the mega subwoofers. Number one, first and foremost, performance. These things are amazing sounding. The room pressurization has to be experienced to be believed. They're smart subwoofers, and we'll get into why in a second. And they have wireless built in, which you guys are going to love from an install perspective. And there's plenty of choice. So you're going to make sure your customer gets something that's right for them. We're going to skim through this because we've got, let me check the time here. We've got about 7 minutes, so I don't want to take too long on this. But you can see there's no hardware. All the screw heads are hidden on this product. The grill attaches with these soft grip attachments, so you get no rattling. It comes with feet and carpet spikes in the box. We've spoken about the finishes. The amplification is very high quality. Bash is kind of a combination of A, B, and D class amplification. So you get great performance all the way through the output stage, loud or quiet. We use cast baskets on this product for rigidity and quality. Aluminium paper cone blend for that stiffness and responsiveness that we spoke about earlier on in the deck. Massive voice coils, massive motors for huge amounts of travel and air movement. Absolutely rock solid cabinet. These are heavy, by the way, as well. We're talking up to 83 pounds for the biggest one. 48, 79, 83 pounds. Those are the heaviest three. So you might want to take a friend when installing them just to get them out of the truck and into the house. And then that rib surround that we spoke about that's consistent across all of the episode range. So this is what an S series looks like. We're very, very similar to the previous slide, right? Rib surround, you can see obviously we don't have two drivers in this model. Premium matte finish. We've got the carpet spikes and rubber feet. Again, you're not going to get any rattles from the grill as it goes in. You get a much better view of that hidden hardware here up on the screen. You know, all those screws are hidden away. It looks beautiful. Massive voice coils, massive magnets, a stamped basket. We went for a Kevlar paper cone on this. Again, nice and light, very responsive. The cabinet is made from the same material for rigidity. And we just have that different power, but same technology of amplifier built in. The back panels look just as you'd expect. A couple of things to call out though, the D series has balanced audio inputs, and you'll note that there's an Ethernet port and a wireless pair button on the back of each product. So we used a sealed design on these subwoofers, and that's harder to do and it's more expensive, but you get better sound. So bottom line is we wanted to take care of the performance more than anything. It's harder to do, but it was the right thing to do for our flagship speaker line. So here's some examples on the screen you guys can read through if you watch this back. So the subwoofers have a smart aspect to them, which is kind of unusual in the subwoofer world. But you know, as we move forward in the world of control systems and everything having a network address these days, it was totally the right thing to do. So let me tell you about why this is important and what we can do with this. What does it mean? First of all, we can turn the sub on and off using a control system. So you're not waiting for signal sensing to kick in. And often, I don't know about you guys, but I've experienced it where maybe I'm watching a movie and there's no bass, or there's, you know, some quiet talking, for example, for a prolonged period of time. Then of course, when the subwoofer, when the bass is required, the, you know, soundtrack kicks in or there's an explosion or something, it takes a few seconds for the subwoofer to kick in. So you're not going to experience that when you can actively turn this up on and off with the rest of your AV system. We also have a local UI that's going to let you change the name of the subwoofer. And this is really cool, is you can start doing stuff automatically when you have a control system driver. For example, I have a 4-month-old daughter, and in the evenings, I don't want the whole house thundering and shaking. And so I can automatically, this is so cool, automatically put the subwoofer into night mode when it gets past 6 p.m. at night, and then pop the subwoofer back into day mode at 7 o'clock the next morning, or whatever you want, really. And so this gives you the opportunity to, I think, just go the extra mile, you know, go that extra step with your customers and give them an experience that really delights them, makes them really happy. The Sub also has a companion app that works with Apple and Android phones. The app's really for both the installer, you guys, and the customer too. So as a dealer, you can get the subwoofer set up and installed properly, dial it all in, build those presets. And we also have this really awesome auto EQ function, which I'll show you on the next slide. The homeowner can use the app for turning on and off the subwoofer. Maybe they don't have a control system, so they can turn the subwoofer on and off from their phone. They can recall any presets like movie or night mode, and even fine tune the performance. Auto EQ is super simple. All you need to do is place your phone on the top of the subwoofer and kind of initiate the process. The sub's going to emit some test tones. When complete, position yourself back in the listening position, and the sub will repeat that frequency sweep, analyze the data, and dial in the internal adjustments to make sure that the sub is really optimized for not only the room, but the position of the sub in the room. And you can also do a quick comparison. There's a auto EQ on and off setting, so you can really hear the difference that is made. We have wireless technology built in. So every Mega Sub has a wireless receiver inside it. This gives you guys a great opportunity to place the sub in more locations around the room and not be limited to the pre-wire. It's worth mentioning the existing transmitter from Episode isn't compatible with Mega Subwoofers. So there's a different radio chip in the Mega Subwoofers. So make sure you use our new wireless transmitter. This is built just for the Mega Subwoofers. It connects to your preamp or AV receiver and is easily mounted and hidden away. It has about 50-foot range, by the way. So this is an example of what you come across if you were limited to the pre-wire. You've obviously got one wire going to one subwoofer coming from one AV receiver. When you use our wireless transmitter, you can really put the subwoofer anywhere in the room as long as there's a power outlet. And I think you can do up to 3 subwoofers with that wireless transmitter. So you can even have more than one sub in a room, which again is never a problem. There's no one has ever said to me there's too much bass in this room, so feel free to add more. So number 4, choice. You know, we've got these single and dual drivers. We have all these different sizes available: 8-inch, 10-inch, 12-inch, and 15-inch. And then we've got these really premium finishes. You know, the very modern matte black. The gloss black, the piano black, and then this premium walnut finish. So, quick reminder of what we've spoken about here with Mega Subwoofers. We've got incredible performance. These are smart subwoofers, unusual these days and super cool. Wireless technology built in, making it easier to install. And you've got plenty of choice to make sure your customer's happy with the finish. All right, Q&A time. We are unfortunately 1 minute over time. I apologize, everybody, for that. Matt, do we have any questions?
We did not have any other questions come in on the Mega Sub, so I think that was awesome. I think you covered it extremely well, and yes, I was definitely a kid in a candy store, and these things are amazing, so I encourage you to check them out.
Brilliant. Yeah, way to go. Great presentation, man. You came in under the wire, but you know, with a lot of these, it's a little loose. We've got, you know, friends on here that genuinely, I love the interaction throughout the whole time. Yes, you were mentioning that this is, you can go back and record this. I'm going to have this whole slide deck email to you guys as well. Matt, a Q&A here. Jason asking, what technology is used for wireless subs? Not sure what you meant by technology. Do you want
to? It's a proprietary 2.4 gigahertz wireless point-to-point communication.
Yeah, worth mentioning as well that, you know, this we've tested this, Matt. In fact, I think you actually live with this, where you have, you know, you've multiple Zigbee devices in the same room as this subwoofer connected wirelessly, and you don't get any crosstalk, no interference. Works just great.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Yep. These have gone through extensive interference testing and very reliable wireless solution.